this video, I'm going to talk about cast iron pans. No, not about how great cast iron pans are and how easy they are to care for despite what you think, and how all the cool cooks use cast iron pans even though you never see a restaurant chef using one. No, one of the many claims to fame for cast iron cookery is a nutritional benefit. Cast iron pans are made of iron, so the question is, are they a great source of iron for your diet? Iron is a very important mineral for our health. We need it for our red blood cells to make hemoglobin, which transports and releases vital oxygen around our bodies. 80% of the iron in our body is found in hemoglobin. But we also need it for muscle myoglobin and for many enzymes which are essential for the function of every cell in our body. Also, iron is involved in the making of amino acids, hormones, and neurotransmitters. The human body, in fact, contains about 2 to 4 grams of iron. Men have around 50 milligram iron per kilogram of body weight, and women have around 38 milligrams. At certain times, we need even more iron. For example, we all need more iron during times of growth, and women need more iron while pregnant. Despite how much iron there is in our environment, we may not get nearly as much of it from our diets as we think. It has been estimated that the average American diet derives anywhere from 5 to 7 milligrams of iron from 1,000 calories for an average diet. So this question of iron from cast iron cooking is not trivial. If a lot of the iron from the pan leaches into the food, this will make a big difference. Now, not all the iron in our diet comes in the same form. There are two sources of iron in our diet, heme iron and non-heme iron. It is easy to remember the difference. Heme refers to the blood, so heme iron is iron that is derived mainly from hemoglobin. Heme iron, because of the form it comes in, is readily absorbed and easily assimilated. Non-heme iron, however, tends to be bound with other food components. It has to be hydrolyzed, digested, or solubilized in the GI tract before it can be absorbed. Many proponents of the superiority of cast iron cookery will tell you that cooking in cast iron is a great source of iron because the iron can be leached into the food you cook, thus providing an additional source of dietary iron. And if you cook acidic foods, such as tomato, you get even more iron this way. They will also tell you that this iron is more readily absorbed than iron from other food sources such as nuts, fruits, vegetables, and dairy. For example, some claim that while leafy greens are a good source of iron, they also may contain a high amount of oxalic acid, which interferes with iron absorption, thus making cast iron cooking a better source. Nuts, vegetables, fruits, grains, and cast iron skillets are all sources of non-heme iron, and thus they all have the same poor absorption as compared to heme iron. Although cast iron is a way to get additional iron into your diet, to say that it is superior without mentioning sources of heme iron is a mistake. All sources of non-heme iron represent 70 to 90% of our iron intake. Although heme iron sources represent a very low amount of our dietary iron, their superior bioavailability means they may be responsible for up to half of the iron that is absorbed into our body. The very best sources of dietary iron comes from liver and other organ meats. These are things we Americans do not eat much of, but they cannot be equaled as iron sources. Still, red meat is a good source too, as around 50 to 60% of iron in red meat is heme iron. The same is true of fish and poultry. So if you're looking for a way to increase the iron in your diet, cooking with cast iron is one way, but you should not consider it one of the best ways. In addition to these sources, be aware that many grain products such as bread, rolls, pasta, breakfast cereals, grits, and flour are fortified with iron, and so can represent a very good source of additional iron. In addition to simple elemental iron, these foods can use many different iron-containing compounds. Keep in mind that the best sources do not necessarily contain the highest amounts of iron, but the most bioavailable iron. For instance, breakfast cereals are often fortified with 100% of the daily value of iron, but this does not mean they are a better source than beef, liver, or red meat. If you need additional info about iron in your diet, sources of iron, or even iron deficiency anemia, click on the link in the description below.